Dear students, here today we are going to continue the class. I think every one of you following the classes and listening the videos, it is very important. Try to listen carefully and contact me through WhatsApp group. I will clarify your doubts eventually. So in our last class we discussed about the concept of the scope of political science. As I told you, scope is nothing but subject matter what we are going to study. So scope of political science is nothing but the subject matter whatever we are going to cover under the subject matter of the political science. So in detail in our last class, few points regarding about that we have discussed. Now we are going to discuss about the significance of political science. The next is the significance of political science. What is significance? The general meaning of significance is nothing but calling as the importance of political science. So here, what is the importance of political science? Why we should read the subject concepts of political science? These things we are going to discuss in our today's class. In generally, there is society is there, state is there, government is there, political system is there. Like this, all these organs and institutions, societies, associations are among us. We are living among all these organizations and institutions. So as a common man, everyone should know the basic concepts, basic knowledge of such organizations and institutions. That is inevitable and important. Such type of knowledge accumulates or we can gather through study of the subject concepts of the political science. So at first level, the political science explains concepts and theories. It is a very important aspect. As you know that man is a social man and he is a political man. He is going to participate in the political activities and society activities, and he is having a close relationship with the state also. So that for understanding all these relations, every man should have the basic knowledge of the state, basic concepts of the society, theories of the state and government. These are very important for his day-to-day activities, so that whenever he is going to read the subject concepts of political science, he is able to understand such concepts and theories of different organizations and institutions. Political science provide the man these knowledges, these concepts, these theories. Whenever he is going to learn them, he can participate in a full-fledged manner with a satisfactory aspects. He gets much knowledge. He is able to participate in the activities of the state and government. So everyone should read the political science. And the next one, political science examines forms and organs of government. Here two things are there. One is the forms, other point is the organs. As I told you, government is of different forms. There is a parliamentary form of government is there, presidential form of government is there, dictatorship form of government is there, monarchy form of government is there. These are the different types of forms of government. You are going to learn about them in your future classes in detail. But here you try to just listen and remember the forms of government. So the government is an agency of the state. As I told you in last class, what form of government is there in our country, how it is going to work out, what is the difference between these forms of the governments, what is the result, all these things are very must to a common man, so that everyone must read the subject concepts of the political science. If we read them, we are going to know, we can acquire the knowledge of the government. And the next thing is the organs. Here, don't get confusion. Forms are different from organs. Organs, every government, whatever it is in its form, having three organs. That is the legislature, executive, and judiciary. These are the three organs of the government. Whether it may be parliamentary form of government or presidential form of government, these organs are must. What is legislature? Legislature is the law making body. What is executive? Executive is the law enforcement organ. Judiciary is the interpretary organ. For example, courts at all levels in our country, we may set the example of judiciary. In this way, it is going to examine the activities of the organs also. So that whenever anyone is going to read about the subject concepts of political science, he is going to get the knowledge of all these issues. So everyone must and should read the political science to understand these aspects. It is the importance of political science. And the next one, political science enhances knowledge on rights and duties. In our last class, we may basically learn the meanings of the rights and duties. Rights are the demands, claims by an individual. Duties are basically obligations towards to the society and towards to the country. There shall be maximumly rights should be there along with the duties. So the individual must and should know what are the rights, what he can claim, what are his duties, how he can perform his duties towards to the society and country for the progress of the society. There is a dangerous situations are going to be arise if the person is having the rights without duties, that become society become unpeaceful, anarchy. Whereas without rights, if the person or individual is demanding only duties, performing only duties, the state become slavery, that become slavery, that leads to the dictatorship of the authorities. In this way, there shall be a maximum combination of rights and duties for an individual in a country. So the subject concepts of political science is going to explain you, give a brief description regarding about the rights and duties, advantages, disadvantages. It is must for the progress of a society. So everyone should acquire the knowledge of the political science for the well-being of the social conditions. And political science provides knowledge of the political thinkers. You know that from the beginning, from ancient period, there are very different types of political thinkers were there in our country and in the world. They are the main inspirational and forceful persons for the acquiring the knowledge, acquiring the changes in the society. For example, you know, in our lower classes you studied about the concept of the French Revolution. French Revolution was mostly back up by the writings of the Rousseau, Voltaire. These are the political thinkers who motivated the people of the France, and his writings are the inspiration among the people of that country, and which led to the aspect of the French Revolution. And the next one, Karl Marx. You know that Karl Marx belongs to Russia, and in Russia his writings are influenced by the people. So there is a societal changes we experienced during the 18th century which led to the Russian Revolution. And Mao, he belongs to the China. And Gandhiji, he belongs to India. In this way, there is a constructive and conscious concrete steps were taken by these political thinkers to create the awareness among the different peoples of the country. If we are going to study the subject concepts of political science, we are able to learn about all these aspects. And the next one, political science deals with international relations. You know that international relations are nothing but relations among the nations or countries. Now, in the 21st century, international relations are become inevitable. As the modernization occurred, technology developed, dependence of one country on other country is growing day by day. so that there shall be a cooperative relationship should exist between the countries and regional groups, so that every country is trying to have a close relationship between with other neighboring countries. So at this juncture, as we know that international relations are very important, how to maintain such cooperation, how to avoid such conflicts, like that political knowledge we can acquire by going through the subject concepts of the political science. Political science explains about the world organizations. You know that there are WHO, UNO, ITO, like that so many world organizations are there. Out of them, for our subject concept also, United Nations Organization is considered as one of the premier institution. It is having different organs working throughout the world. So, for the maintenance of good international relations, good structure of organization is also important. So, political science explains about all the activities of these organizations. If anyone is going to learn about these things, they have to go through the subject concepts of the political science. In this way, from a individual man to up to a world organizations, world political system, the political science is going to provide the knowledge to the people. So, reading of political science is must. This is generally considered as the importance of the political science. Try to listen, try to understand, don't get unnecessary confusion regarding forms, organs, Mao, Rousseau, Karl Marx, Gandhiji. Just these are example. Get primary knowledge and leave it. In our next forthcoming lessons, we are going to learn them clearly and systematically. Thank you. In our next class, we are going to start comments another topic in this first unit only. Okay, all the best.